Hey y'all, I'm alone again, so I said let me go ahead and get some of these videos filmed because Vlogmas is here and I have to prepare. Okay, so by popular demand, I'm bringing y'all Atlanta content. I'm gonna be sharing some of my favorite places and subscribe. You know, if you are new, I am on the road to 10K. I'd love to have you here. I'm Yosha. I'm your go-to girl for all things real. And today I'm gonna be sharing with y'all some of my recommended date night, date day spots. Everything from under $40 to up to $100-ish. So if that sounds like something that you would be interested in, make sure to watch the full video. I will leave down my last video that I did sharing some spots, as well as my video that I did about things to know before moving to Atlanta. Keep in mind that if it is something that I've already answered, I will direct you to the video so that you can get the full explanation. This first spot I'm talking about is one that I found on TikTok. I'm gonna give y'all the good, the bad, and the ugly because I've been twice. And this is the perfect spot, in my opinion, for a day date or a night date. It's called Puttshack. Puttshack is basically like an adult playground with miniature golf. They have 4 to 6 different courses. You go in, you can choose the course that you wanna play on. It's fun to go as a date because you can be competitive. I went with my husband and I beat him and it was so much fun because he lost. And like, he always beats me at everything, so it was really cool for him to lose. I also went with a group of people, and I will say I did not have as much fun when I went with a group of people because we went and the customer service was kind of eh, and we were having some people that didn't show up on time, so it affected the experience. Tips about going to this place is, number one, this is not a last minute date type place, especially on the weekends. If you go on a Saturday or Sunday, or you want to go on a Saturday or Sunday, be sure to make a reservation. Do not wait until the morning of and try to make a reservation, because the reservations fill up quickly. Second thing you want to keep in mind is if you go at night on a weekend, it's going to be more crowded. Children are allowed to be there before 4 o'clock. I recommend that you try to go on a weeknight. If you want to do a date night, it's going to be a little bit more intimate. It's going to be less noise. The music is a vibe. The aesthetic is a vibe. And you will like it. You could probably make your way through 2 or 3 courses. The drinks were not that great. I tried a margarita the first time I went. Y'all, that margarita was so nasty. I didn't even order a drink the second time that I went. The first time I went, I was celebrating one of my best friend's birthday, and it was like 8 of us. Like I said, some of us did not arrive on time, so they can't start the game until everybody is there. And then we had some hiccups with customer service. I'll leave the Yelp review down below. I went back with my husband a few months later as a date. We went during the week and it was during the day. We had a reservation, we were on time. It went smoothly. It was nice, it was fun. It was, you know, a cool way to spend the afternoon. So definitely give it a shot. And if you do wanna go with a group of friends, you definitely can, but just tell your friends to be on time, okay? The parking, you use the Park Mobile app. I forgot to mention that. Use the Park Mobile app. It's like $2 or $3 an hour. The next place that I'm gonna tell y'all about is my favorite sushi buffet. If you are a lover of sushi, but you don't wanna pay like $18 for 2 rolls of sushi and still be hungry afterwards, consider going to Nori Nori in Sandy Springs. Nori Nori has free parking. My husband put me on a Nori Nori when we were dating. I was in disbelief because all of my buffet experiences with sushi have been, yeah, mediocre at best. Nori Nori gives you an upscale dining experience with their sushi. They have a variety of different options that you can choose from, and they have fried options and they have raw options, and they are very good. In addition to sushi, they have hot foods such as miso soup and crab soup, chicken and salmon kebabs. On the other side of the bar, you'll see like fried rice and spring rolls and lo mein and chicken wings and different cuts of meat and just a variety. So when you go, you may not get the same stuff every time. I do know that during dinner, they sell crab legs. The dinner price is a little bit more than the lunch price. I'll say the main difference with the dinner and lunch is that you're gonna get more seafood options at night. They also have salads. They have green tea ice cream and an array of different desserts. I sincerely love going to this place when I have a sushi craving because the sushi is great and it's made to order. They have a lunch period and they have a dinner period. I want to say the few times I went, lunch was from 12 to 2:30 or 11:30 to 2:30. Then they close for a few hours to prep for dinner. And then they reopen from like 5 to 9 or 5 to 10, depending on the day. Now the price is around $20 during lunch and around $40 during dinner. If you bring your kids, which children can come, it's either gonna be 60% or 80% or 40% of the menu price based on your child's height. So I think that it's a great place to go for a date or with your family. I think it's more of a day date type place though, at best. It's more quiet, it's more intimate. It's not like the nicest aesthetically pleasing place. I mean, they have this cute aquarium and whatnot, but you know, if you're looking for good food and you're a sushi lover, then yes, I think you'd like this spot. Now this option is gonna be for my budget friendly friends, and that's gonna be the Ponce City Market area. Ponce City Market has a whole bunch of stuff for you to do. You can shop, you can eat, you can take some really cute pictures. I had a photo shoot there earlier in the year. I plopped some of my photos there. What I like about Ponce is it's pretty affordable. The parking there is really cheap. It's like $3. Ponce City Market, they have the Park Mobile app as well. When you go to Ponce City Market, you kind of have to know what you want to do. They do have like this adult arcade type area. It's not exactly the same as Puttshack. It's more so like games and things like that. But I'm going to tell y'all the truth. My budget friendly thing that we enjoy doing when we go to Ponce is just walking around and looking at what's going on. Also, we'll sometimes go over to Whole Foods. My husband put me on to the Whole Foods pizza. Y'all, Whole Foods food is actually not bad. If you are on a budget, you can go there and dine in their food court and have a cute little date while you sit there and talk and eat pizza or whatever you want. They have a hot buffet too. I guess this is like the buffet edition because I'm pretty much naming like buffet type style stuff. But I think it's a cute date to do that doesn't have to cost a lot of money. Like you don't have to spend a ton to enjoy somebody's company. And the good thing about Whole Foods is that the food is very healthy. So you're not going to walk away feeling heavy afterwards. If you do decide to try the Whole Foods in Ponce City Market, my recommendation is to try the chicken pesto pizza. It is not one that they typically have just sitting. So what that means is they will make it fresh for you. And y'all, it is so good and it doesn't have bread sauce. So if you have heartburn problems like me, I definitely recommend this type of pizza because it does not give you heartburn and it's very good. It's my husband's favorite. Next, I'm gonna recommend another spot that is kind of fun and has a little aesthetic to it. And it's called Kiku's Japanese Cuisine. I'm gonna pop it on the screen for you guys. This is located in the Camp Creek area and this is a Japanese style restaurant. They have delicious sushi and they also have the hibachi style dining experience where you and your date will sit and do group dining with others. Or you can go with friends or family and they cook in front of you. They do a show, you know, they make the heart on the grill in front of you and make the fire fly up. It's really fun. I've been there several times as a date, as a birthday dinner, as a gathering with my sorority sisters. It's just a cool vibe in the Camp Creek area. I do love the food. I think that they give you a lot of food for the price. And when you go, you can go and just get the chicken if you want to be like on the cheaper side. And it comes with rice, you get a ginger salad, you get miso soup, and you get a little thing of ice cream. Or if you want to splurge and treat yourself, you can get some shrimp and steak and scallops. The scallops were so good, y'all. I also love the Camp Creek roll. If you're a sushi person, you're looking for some sushi, then yeah, you definitely want to try the Camp Creek roll. I thought it was really good. And it's not really that expensive, but it's, you know, it's not on the cheap side either. Like, I would say Kiku's is a little bit less than going to Nori Nori, but it's not a buffet. but you do get a lot of food. When you dine in, whether you go lunch or dinner, you should have enough to take some home for the next meal. And it's just, you know, it's kind of fun watching somebody cook in front of you and give you a shot. The last place that I'm going to tell you about is where my husband and I went for our recent anniversary dinner. This is a more upscale restaurant. It's located in Buckhead. They do have two locations in Atlanta, but we recently dined at the one on Piedmont, and the service was amazing. If anything you take away from this, you have to know like where you're going, when you're going, and what is the goal of your date, right? So if you are looking for a more intimate experience, consider going out on a date when it's the weeknight. I know it sounds weird, and I know it's not convenient because a lot of us work during the week and we're off on weekends, or some of y'all might not be off on weekends, but I promise if you experience going somewhere on an evening during the week, it's going to be much more intimate. It's going to be less chances of mistakes happening. Fogo de Chão was an amazing experience. The food was good, the service was good. They gave us complimentary cheesecake to celebrate our anniversary, and I definitely recommend it. But just bring your wallet, because it's expensive. If you want to save, go during lunch, because it's much cheaper during lunch. It's like $20 or $30 during lunch, and like $60 during dinner per person. But it's like a buffet style. They bring you high quality meats to your table. My favorite was the lamb chops and the garlic steak. So that concludes this video. Let me know what your favorite date night spot in Atlanta is if you live here. If you have any questions or you want a part two to this video, let me know in the comment section down below. Thank you for watching. I'll see you all in my next video. Bye.